In today's video, I thought I would just play around with ABBYY FineReader PDF 16. The first thing that I'm going to do is select OCR editor, and then I'm going to choose a file on my computer, and it should begin to OCR everything. So the first thing that I notice is I have a list of thumbnails on the far left-hand side. This document has 7 pages in it, and what ABBYY FineReader tries to do at first is to zone all of the content on the left-hand side. The blue is a text area, red or pink is a image area, and then we also have green is the table area. Now on the right-hand side, we have the text panel of ABBYY FineReader, which is different than the image panel. So the image panel contains the visual display of the PDF, and the text panel is the underlying text of the document. And what we want to do is just validate that this looks correct. So as far as I can tell, everything is right. Now the first thing I like to do is just make sure all of the zones are good. And just with a quick visual scan, I can tell we have text, 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 and an image. Now what I want to do is select the reorder areas zone, and I want to make sure that our content is in the right reading order. And then from here, let's move on to page 2. Again, we have sample 2, a tree icon, and some text. Now, if I wanted to, I could delete the image zone out of the image panel, and it removes it from the text panel. This is essentially an advanced way to artifact content from within a PDF. So the icon will visually stay in the PDF, but it will not be inside of my exported document. All right, in this example, we have a background image followed by some OCR text that's actually on the page. Now, I don't really have a problem with the text being OCR'd here, but we just want to make sure it's correct. So over here where I see non-wilderness, I'm just making sure that everything is spelled correctly, and then I'm moving on to the other parts of the document. Now, this example document, this content on the bottom should actually be image, so I'm just going to select it there and mark it as an image. And it is coming through appropriately. Let's go ahead and move on to page 4. So in this case, we have text, and then we have an arrow that I want to make an image. And then if I wanted to, I could re-recognize this page just to make sure that it was inserted correctly. And again, we have our text, and the image is coming through. Let's check out page 5. Now we have a data table, and this appears to be tagged or zoned appropriately, and I know that because I can click into every one of the cells. If this wasn't zoned properly, I would simply grab the table zone area and draw a box around the table, and then there's an option called Analyze Table Structure. This again will separate all of your rows and columns and cells. Let's move on to the next page. We have text, we have an image, text, text, and image, and some more text with links, and it comes through absolutely perfectly. Now, something that's interesting with ABBYY FineReader, you can now add alternate text to images. All right, let's go to our page 7, and we have a table of contents and a picture, but all in all, everything came through perfectly. So now if I wanted to, I can save this out as a searchable PDF, which is what I'm going to do first. But before we get to that, please take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. And let's take a look at the tags panel. So we have a document tag, which is fantastic. We have a heading 1 tag, followed by a full list. We have a figure with a caption. This would need to be adjusted, of course. And our text. If we remember correctly, on page 2, the tree icon is on the page, but it's not tagged. This is great. We then have on page 3, some of our content is being tagged from the pie chart. And I realized something that I messed up in this is I should have set the reading order of this page because it's all out. But the important part is all of the content got transferred through. We have a little bit of blur on our links, but otherwise, this document looks really good. Or we could simply run the accessibility checker, and that should find any issues with the alt text. We would want to fix our table headers and so on. What if we wanted to take our document into Microsoft Word? Well, we can do that too. Instead of selecting the save button for PDF, I would change the drop-down menu to save as Microsoft Word document. Let's try editable copy and then select save. And I'm going to overwrite my other file, and let's open up our Word document. And again, we have a bunch of inserted text boxes. which is not ideal. Let's go back to ABBYY FineReader again, and this time let's save it as formatted text and select save. Back to Word. Aha, and now we have a document that is much easier to work with. Is it perfect? No, it's not perfect. But this did allow me to get the majority of the content OCR'd and into Microsoft Word so that I can begin to start editing this document further. Now, if you don't want to deal with going from PDF to Microsoft Word or Word to PDF or making your documents accessible, this is a service I provide to people. I can make your documents accessible to whatever standards you want, or you can check out my other videos to learn how to make your own files accessible. And as always, thank you for joining me today, and I can't wait to see you next time.